So here we go, Liang getting this men's quarter final off and running. Wow. Exhibition point for starters.
Honestly, I've never seen Ma Long start a match this way, but Liang got him back there. Fascinating start.
One love.
Imagine if that was intentional by Ma Long, just to get in ahead of Liang. Imagine that's how far ahead he's thinking.
One four.
It's not obvious with Ma Long's game, but I'm sure he's got many mental mind game tricks up his sleeve. Things that he does in between points or even during them to affect the opponent.
One, two.
Well, I think at the top level of any sport, there is an element that is psychological warfare as well as actually what goes on the field of play.
Yeah.
You're looking for any edge you can get.
Well, Ma Long was forged literally in the fire pit of the greatest ever China generation. Oh, tries the interesting shot there. I think went for the fanning backhand, but a really kind of jagged one down the line. That would have been butchered if it would have landed.
Three, four.
Serve had Liang in some difficulty.
Four all. Five, four. Five,
four. Nippon took first ten there. What a fortune for Ma. There's the iconic forehand. The subtle
six,
serve.
Five.
He's had that silhouette basically his whole career. Best servers aren't the most flamboyant servers. They're the craftiest, the most cunning, most deceptive. And the deception comes from the simplicity in some sense as well. The complexity is kind of embodied within its simplicity.
So they were 3-all at the first towelling break, now they're 6-all at the second. Very tight out there in this opener. Well, that was almost a repeat the other way around, wasn't it, at the first point?
6-7.
Can't see Liang lobbing down Ma Long. Not quite Xu Xin in that department of the game. See how he twiddles there. He actually smashes with the backhand side because it's a softer rubber. More likely to go on. More safe. Oh my word.
What a point. That's why people say he's the greatest of all time.
Well, it's him and Voldemort that are most common in that conversation, and that was a Voldemort-esque shot. A forehand scoop below the table with side and almost backspin there.
Almost a look of disbelief from Liang.
Got so much feeling, Ma Long. So much touch. As well as the out-and-out aggression.
Well, they're feeding off each other. They're producing some magnificent play. And that man in particular. And even though Liang has contributed hugely to what we've seen so far in this first game, just get the feeling Ma Long's got his number.
He's so relaxed, isn't he?
So far, at least.
Even brought out the chop block in that rally and dismissed Liang's snake shot. You just can't kid Ma Long. So hard to fool him. It's a viral moment when he is tripped. Endless amount of wisdom.
Four game points. Well, if the rest of the match lives up to the first game.
Love one.
Well, I think it's imperative for Liang to win this game. If he goes two love down, you would struggle to see him coming back against a man he's never beaten in five previous attempts.
I just can't see it happening. Ma Long has so many strings to his bow, has so many ways to change the rhythm. How many out-and-out attacking players has Ma Long fended off?
Missed that one.
Three, love.
In terms of their attacking prowess, they're both so similar. But it's the craftiness, the cunningness of Ma Long that has come with his experience.
One, three.
And there's the mental side of it is massive, I think, as well.
He's not always been a winner. He's lost many times. Difference is he doesn't see it as a loss. Sees it as a learning experience.
Well, terrific shot. He had Liang scampering across the table, never going to really be able to get there to control the shot.
Great play there. I think that's one advantage, well, one strength that Liang might have over Ma Long. The backhand over the table. Liang's is more explosive and Ma Long's is more divisive.
Five, two.
That said, Liang getting himself into a promising position in the second game.
Wow,
speed of that rally.
Unfathomable. How easy they make it look.
Five.
wider, that serve there from the Dragon. Five. With a lot of backspins. I think it was anyway. I'll have to see it again. Looked like that though.
Let 4-5.
Ooh.
6-4.
Even though it hit the net there, I mean, you could hear how quiet the contact was, how fine the contact was of Liang's open up. So, so spinny. He's done it again, Ma Long.
And then Jim Bimbo to something extravagant.
Ma Long is taking the mick here. Then Liang trying to do what Ma Long did to him, the forehand hook.
Is that a little disrespectful what Ma Long was doing, maybe?
Oh, you know what? Yes, and I love it. But it's effective. He knows Liang isn't going to have a clue what to do with it, apart from kind of try and push it back. It's basically unsmashable, that ball that he's giving there, the fanning backhand.
I heard the oohs and ahs in the crowd when he played those shots.
Oh, it's sexy, isn't it? It's amazing how you can think so clearly and outside the box under pressure on a completely different wavelength from mere table tennis mortals.
Still behind in this game, though.
Mm. This is the thing about Liang. He is a busybody, and he doesn't make it easy because he's so consistent. There, just leaned back a little bit on that open up. Didn't keep his posture. Ma Long switching and then going cross court. The X's and the H's on the table, we call it.
Seven all.
That's unbelievable. That shouldn't be possible.
When you think he's shown everything he's had to show in this career, look at the walk as well.
The walk and the look. Like it was nothing.
Can you imagine putting that national jersey on in the morning, seeing your name on the back, being Ma Long?
Time out.
Yeah, not surprised after that.
Eight all.
Well, there's no bonus points for a trick shot. Liang is still here.
I wonder what's going through Liang's mind. Played a few trick shots now, and you know this is a WTT star contender quarter final.
Nine eight.
Crunches it there. Full swing. He wanted that flick and he got it. And it was curtains.
It was a speeding spheroid past that man before he even had time to react, really.
Six. 8-10.
He's worn him down and he's earned himself two game points for a two love lead. And as I said earlier, if that happens, you really can't see the end from Kim coming back. Stranger things have happened. And Marlon needs to get over the line in this second game first, but just one more point needed to do that. A little defeatist, isn't it, that expression? Well, that pretty much sums up.
One love.
You do sometimes have to generalise it, because if you deep it too much, you'll overthink your shot.
Well, they say the longest journey starts with a single step. It's a long journey back here for Liang Jingkun. Especially if Marlon keeps doing that. But all Liang can do is just take it one point at a time and hope at some point that man's level drops a little bit, because at the moment he's basically unplayable.
One, two.
And Liang, for a big guy, scampers around the court, very active, works on the balls of his feet. This is one of the most complete players in the game, and he's still getting dismantled here. This is a three-time World Championship bronze medalist in singles.
Three,
one. Of the most unbeatable players of this generation right here. And basically every other sentence is about what an amazing shot it is by Ma Long.
Yes, exactly.
The oldest player to represent China in men's singles is Wang Lichin at 35. Ma Long's only a year younger than that record. And playing as well as he's ever played, if not better. You can see the definition in the legs. Ma Long is looking after himself very well indeed.
Two, four.
Well, he's 35 in a fortnight, so he's going to be not far away from 36 if he's in Paris.
Hunting for his third singles gold. No one's ever even won two apart from him. Put that in perspective, will you?
Three, four.
That would be complete domination over a period of 12 years straight.
Well, if anyone can.
Four, all.
And he'd won eight ATTF tournaments before the age of 22.
Five, four.
Such power, but such control with it. The Ancient King is doing everything he possibly can just to hang on here, just hang on in there and hope something goes his way. Still in this third game, obviously. Never know. Rally.
It takes five.
Is there anything he can't do?
No,
toe
Trevor.
To toe.
Yeah, there is something that he can't do. Lose.
Well, he doesn't do that very often. What an astonishing exchange this was.
You've got to feel for Liang here.
Well, he was throwing the kitchen sink, wasn't he, at Marlong? And everything was coming back with interest. What a point.
Yeah, what a point indeed. You have to say it's more reactive from Liang than initiative, despite the length of that rally. How can he get in front of Marlong early on?
Well, Liang knew exactly what was coming there. He just basically put up the white flag.
That's for a short serve is coming in so quick. When you watch table tennis live for the first time, you'd be amazed to see how actually fast professional players play the short serve. You haven't got barely any time to think at all. Liang there didn't have the time to play the flick. He had to touch because it was such a low and tight serve, and it was topspin and he didn't even know it. It's just so much trouble straight from the get-go.
Well, this is one of 11 matches today, and this contest alone will be worth the admission money twice over.
Oh, wow. I mean, it was a gorgeous little spin up from Liang off the half long, but he's still prepared for it, Marlong. Still plays about four shots after it.
Eight, six.
Credit for that to the engine Kun, who's taken a barrage of blows from this man and just fired back one in anger at the dragon.
Flick from Liang, flicking through the fingers. That's the Chinese philosophy, really focusing a lot of attention on the fingers, the pressure on certain fingers, so important. The body follows that once a player's anticipated how to react to a certain shot, how to make a certain shot.
Well, this is a courageous little comeback here from the engine Kun.
It's felt in terms of content like a five-gamer.
Yeah. Still in there battling.
Nine, eight.
And he's got designs on extending this match. It seemed highly improbable a few minutes ago.
Ooh, some jam.
8-10.
But still, actually, the serve itself made Marlong second guess. Shows how well actually Liang's played. The fact that he's got game points here on an informed dragon.
Two chances then to reduce the deficit.
Nine, ten.
Can't think too linearly here, Liang. Gonna do something different to throw off the dragon's rhythm. Can't just give him something ordinary. It's got to be hot, or it's got to be clever. Hot and clever, preferably.
He's got it.
11-9.
We are going to have a fourth game.
Love one.
Isn't it? It just never fails to amaze you how fast the mood can change, isn't it? in a Fast and Furious 5-game format up to the finals.
And the boost that the ancient club would have got from winning that game, almost incalculable.
Wow.
We're off again.
One. He played the first four balls of that rally perfectly, Liang. Pushed to the corner, blocked to the open space, a mile-long lunges, spreads his wings. And you've got to fear for Liang in the loop-to-loop rally, the 4 mile-longs in. Calibrating every single counter. I mean, he is the king of all time when it comes to loop-to-loop rallies.
One, two. One.
I think he's a bit miffed. I don't think he wanted to go four games.
To a perfectionist, anything can be a stain on the record. But it isn't a flawless victory.
He certainly doesn't want to give the ancient king the sniff here in this fourth game. Because if it does go five, anything can happen. Best of one. Let's get it done right now in this fourth game. 3-1.
Three, two.
Well, Liang has taken Ma Long to the deciding game twice. Back in 2018 and 2019, though it was quite a few years ago.
Three, all.
What does Liang Chingqing have to do to win a point? Absolutely astonishing.
The balls that he reacted to there, Darpont. Insane. Ma Long steps into the slower balls. Unbelievably.
Shots that last rally.
Well, overcooks it there.
It's almost a groan of disbelief when he misses one. He's only human. And Liang is just trying to stay on his coattails and doing a pretty good job of it at the moment, considering the pressure he's been put under.
It's almost heroic from Liang here.
Five, four.
Liang takes his forehand a little bit later than Ma Long, so it's more of a whippy effect than Ma's kind of striking. It's a bit more spin on it, but I'd say less penetration. It can be tough to block.
Turn it off! Five, six.
Just not letting him get comfortable there. A long push to middle with the backhand from Ma. Don't see him push with the backhand so often, but probably knows that, and that's why he did it that time, going against the grain to surprise Liang.
Got it! 7-5.
Extends more there, Ma Long. Watch this. Drops the bat, brushes it a little bit more, just to add arc. Constantly changing the flight of the ball against your opponent who's doing the same. It's just amazing, absolutely amazing. Two ahead, Ma Long.
Oh!
Oh! Ma Long, you naughty boy! That's going to have to be a yellow card. Well, this is going to be an interesting moment.
Ma.
Jasper Tan.
Got it! Oh. 6-8.
Well, responding well initially out of this timeout. Gets vocal now, Ma.
Seven, eight.
And just the odd miss will just keep Liang Jingkun interested here. We haven't seen many short game battles, have we, that set up that eventual winner for Ma Long?
Not so many, no. I'm just amazed at Ma Long's confidence to push long and hold the table here against one of the biggest hitters, especially from the backhand, away from the table. I mean, his forehand as well, impeccable, Liang, but... Yeah, Ma, so composed near the table, just controlling the rally. Making small adjustments, enough to throw off Liang.
Ten.
It's good enough without getting
seven.
Help. And that net cord, but kill the ball stone dead, gives Ma Long three match points.
That is a scintillating counter there from Liang Jingkun. Look at that. Against match point as well. His effort has been undying.
Well, I guess he also thinks now, no guts, no glory. May as well go out. In a blaze if he's going to go out. Only a couple of points required, though, to make things interesting again.
And he's got the serves, the almighty serves.
Fantastic display from Ma Long, a brilliant spectacle. Credit to Liang Jingkun.